isolation drive is currently underway, and we understand that, you know, all safety protocol that's being followed over here. But you know, coming back to the problem over here at hand, what we understand, you know, that you said with regard to you know, the full turnout. Now that is something, you know, the union government has maintained that Karnataka has had, in fact, you know, the highest number of healthcare workers being vaccinated in the first 4 days. It's more than 80,000 workers, and all of, you know, of course, these people that you see here right now are those who have actually got the vaccination and are in the waiting period of 30 minutes. So as far as, you know, the concerns that have been raised by some of the resident doctors are concerned, what they've actually gone on to say is that, you know, they want to be given a choice of which vaccine to be administered to them, simply because one of the vaccines, you know, is still in the third phase of the clinical trial. So, in fact, I'm joined right now, Tanuba, by Dr. Mahendra, who happens to be, you know, the medical director of the hospital that we're at. He's going to help us understand a little bit more. Sir, first of all, I'd like to ask you, you know, yesterday was the first day of the vaccination drive at this hospital. And while we're, you know, talking about some concerns that some doctors, you know, might have had across the state or across the country for that matter, how was the turnout over here at the hospital, and did any of your staff express any concerns?
Yeah, out of 300 people who were stipulated for yesterday, who had been scheduled for vaccination, the first phase, you know, at 10 o'clock when we started, actually, there was some slight apprehensions on people, like, you know, who's going to take it first. So there was some small scare, what we could see in their faces. So then that was the time I stepped inside and said that, you know, I'll be the first volunteer to sit down and take the first vaccine. So once I got it, then there's so much of confidence building was there with everyone. And almost by the end of the day, we could complete almost 260 people.
Okay.
So there were a few people who were still apprehensive, but then they quoted some kind of a scare, you know, back in their minds, and their probably their parents said, or some nurses said that their parents have told them not to get vaccinated.
Okay.
But we didn't force them.
Yeah.
Since
yeah.
it was purely mandatory, we didn't want to force them at all.
Okay. Now, sir, you know, another thing is that in many parts we're seeing that, you know, the app or the COVID app, you know, has been throwing up some sort of problems in terms of glitches and, you know, hanging, or the app isn't allowing for, you know, database. So on a ground level, you know, were there any issues with that, or largely was it okay?
No, it is true that even we had some technical glitches where we could not update the data live as and when it happened. So we, for some time there was a hang up, and we had to do all the things manually.
Okay.
Later on, by the evening, we could link up, and we added a lot of data back.
Okay.
So by late around 8 o'clock in the night, we actually completed loading up all the data.
Okay, all right, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, you know, Tarana, of course, that is what the medical director of the Sagar Hospital here had to say, that, you know, despite, of course, some glitches, they did manage to wrap up the procedure by the end of the day. But having said that, we also have to, you know, tell you what the health minister of Karnataka has said, stating that the vaccine, you know, this is with regard to the concerns raised by the resident doctors. He's gone on to say that the vaccine is not mandatory. At the end of the day, it is voluntary, and those, you know, who do not want to take it should not. But at the same time, he's also made an appeal to the doctors to come forward, and he's gone on to state that, you know, since both the vaccines have been approved by the central government, the doctors must come forward. So with regard to the concerns raised by these residents across the state, that's Shivamoga, Ballari, Chamarajanagar, several other districts, we'll have to wait and see whether going forward now the government gives them a choice of choosing which vaccine they want to take, or whether it is assigned to them the way it has been all these days.
Right. In fact, that is one of the centers or one of the states that we can see there are rising concerns over Covaxin. Thank you so much, Neha, for joining us with that report.